to Heart with Sibongile Mofokeng on Radio Pulpit. Heart to
Heart. Give you the sounds of Mama Rebecca Malupe, Dr. Rebecca Malupe, and the song says, Sibongile, protect us, oh God. And I'm laughing because it says that in heaven there's no middle class, no, you know. We are all equal in the eyes of the Lord. And so, yeah, beautiful sounds. And Sibongile, protecting. And we're talking to Pastor Sublime Mkonto about protecting and training our children, teaching them more to build their own relationship with the Lord, training them to walk with God. This is what we're talking about. But before I greet him, Pasco Graphics, hello to you. Thank you so much. Pasco made some comments right there when we were talking to Casey Chambers, and we were talking about raising awareness on paying attention to our children's mental health. And you did mention that it's a tough one. It's a tough one. But I would like to say, and you said thanks for the awareness, but we'd like to say it's a tough one, but it's doable through Christ. He enables us. He is our teacher. The Lord Holy Spirit is our teacher, and he can teach us on how to do this. And we make sure that, and we ensure that our children's mental health is sound. And so I'm delighted we're talking further about protecting them and now training them training them to walk with God. And let me greet Obu James Ferdinand Van Zyl on the other side. Dumela hle abuti, re a rata le rona. Thank you for joining us. And on the line, I'm joined by Pastor Sublime Elton Spear Mkonto. Muruti, how are you?
I'm good, my dear sister, and how are you?
I'm good. And how's Tula Hamahashi today?
Oh, Tulamaji is great. At least it's not so cold today.
Uh-huh.
And it's not raining.
Is it? So does it even get cold at Tulamahashi? I don't expect Tulamahashi to be cold.
It actually gets cold. It actually gets cold, but just a bit, of course.
Ay, pala, the heat.
Unlike yours, that side. So here, it's always hot. So when it's a bit cold, we say it's very chilly.
Oh, my goodness. Ah, pela Tulamahashi, Bushbuck Ridge is hot. So I'm like, it's just like Venda. You know, when I hear somebody in Venda saying, your Venda is very cold today, I'm like, hi, bo, kanjani.
Yeah, those places are very hot. Actually, Venda is hotter than our area.
Yeah, Mokopani and Venda, they are much hotter than Tulamahashi.
Yes.
Well, Muruti, we are talking about, and let me welcome you to the family. And you're not coming to listeners here on Heart to Heart, but we have family. So welcome to the family, and family members will be tuned in listening to our talk. Mfundisi, we're talking about protecting and training our children, training them to walk with God. Where do we begin in terms of protecting them? Because there's a lot that we need to protect our children from. If we don't teach our children, if we don't train our children ourselves, the world talks to our children. Social media talks to our children. Their peers talk to them. There's always a voice in our children's lives. When we are not doing it, somebody else is doing it. And they might not even be doing it the way we desire it to be done, not the godly way that we would want them to. So where do we begin when we're talking about protecting them? We're always telling our children, don't talk to strangers, don't do this, don't do that. But are we also training them, or are we just talking to them? So where does it begin when we're talking about protecting them?
You know, I think it all begins with us allowing them to know God for themselves. And that means taking them to a place where they will get to know God, understand God's ways of doing things. And it's not about don't do this, don't do that, don't do with that one, don't do it. Because the moment you say don't, what comes to their mind is, what could be behind the way it's done? So they are definitely going to want to experiment to see what are you talking about. But if we get them to a place where they can know God for themselves, and they see God as a father who protects, because I think some of us, we grew up so well by reason of being in God. It had nothing to do with where we're coming from. But just being introduced to God in the first place, it made a great deal of difference in our lives. So In God, we are very much safe. I can safely say that.
Mm.
In God, we are very much safe.
Most of us, Muruti, sorry, a little bit. Most of us, I was talking to Cassie Chambers just now, and we were talking about also paying attention to the mental health of children. And most of us, a child doesn't understand anything. We look at them, they are 4, they are 3, they are 5, we're like, no, they're still in the dark. This is what we say even in the township. So when is the right time to start introducing our children to the Lord? I mean, from me, I believe in talking to my child about God from even when they are in my tummy. And when they are here and they just looking at me and suckling the breast, I share the word with them. But not all parents are doing that. And so how soon should you start introducing your child to the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings?
You know, the truth is, as early as you possibly can, once you have them in your arms, you start teaching them about God.
Mm.
I'll give you an example. You know, I've seen people make bricks.
Yeah.
And one of the things that happens when they are making bricks is that some of the bricks will not come out perfectly well. So if it is not perfectly well, they dissolve it immediately and make it according to the way they want it to be.
Hmm.
But after 2-3 days, you can't go back to the same brick and want to dissolve it and then remake it.
Yeah.
It doesn't work. Because now it's dry, so it has taken that shape. So whatever you're trying to bring into it, it doesn't work because it's too late.
Yeah.
And it's the same thing with children. If you leave them until they've learned from the outside world, until they've listened to people from the outside, whatever you're going to come with, you should know that it's no longer coming on an empty mind.
Hmm.
It is now coming on a mind that has been filled with certain words from certain people, and we come from different altars on the other hand.
Mm.
So whatever I'm giving to the child could be from a different altar, a strange altar, and you were never there to teach your child. So the best way to teach children, actually, or the best time to teach them is now, when you still have a chance to do so.
Mm.
And while they can still listen to you.
Okay. How do we do this, Mfundisi?
Here is the thing. I strongly believe that we can't teach our children by saying, this is what you need to do, and this is what you should not do, and it ends there.
Yeah.
They need to see it in us.
Okay.
We need to walk it out. If they can see us working out our salvation, if they can see us walking it out, they will definitely follow after our footsteps.
Mm.
There is an attorney in the U.S. that I once listened to, and he was actually going to a bar every morning before he goes to his law firm.
Mm.
He would pass by a bar, and he didn't need to drive there, so because it was so close to his house.
Mm.
So one time, as he's walking towards the gate of the bar, he sees his 4-year-old coming right behind him.
Yeah.
And the 4-year-old is actually walking on his footprints.
Mm.
And he made a turn because he had already entered now the gate. He made a U-turn, and he picked up the child. He ran with the child back home.
Mm.
When he got home, he took the child to them and put him on the mother's laps, and then he went to his bedroom and he cried to God and said, God, forgive me for leading my son to the bar. So it could have been that, okay, I'm going to get one beer and that's it. That's just for me.
Mm.
But not knowing that you are actually influencing the child, because they will do what you do, not just what you say.
Mm.
You produce after your own kind. You don't produce what you say, but you produce who you are. So if you don't deal with who you are first and foremost, you're going to tell your children 20 years later, we used to walk with God, we used to love God, we used to do this and that for God. But it's not going to have an effect because it's not something that you wear yourself. So I think the best way to teach our children, first and foremost, is for us to become it. So if I want to teach my child the values of loving people, respecting people, being humble, loving God, being prayerful, studying the word, I do it myself. They see it in me. And if they can see it in me, they will surely become it. So it begins right there. It begins right there. We have to check ourselves first and foremost.
So you become that which you want your child to become.
Yes, you become that which you want your child to become. You don't just tell your child, you become it yourself. Our children may not say much about what we do, but they see everything. I mean, they see, for an example, how we treat our spouses.
Right.
They see how we respect each other
right.
in their presence. They see how we shout at each other. They see all these things. And the unfortunate part is that we are not aware that in raising this child, you are actually raising someone's husband, you are raising someone's wife tomorrow.
So
and they are definitely going to be who we were.
Sure. So in everything that we do as parents, we need to remember that we are painting a canvas. We are busy
yes.
painting that canvas. Okay. Because
yes,
it comes as empty as it is, but we are the ones that decide what goes onto the canvas.
Yes, yes.
Sure.
And that is why, you see, when it comes to the raising of our children,
yeah.
we can't delegate it to the schools where they spend time at.
And we have.
We can't delegate it to the church.
Mm.
We can't delegate it even to the government. It is our God-given responsibility.
Sure.
It is our God-given responsibility. We have to play it ourselves. I mean, think about this, my sister.
Okay.
Children could be spending about, let's say, 5 hours, 6, 7, 8 hours at school.
Right.
And then they spend 2 hours at church. And they spend the other hours at home. And at church, remember, we don't go to church every day.
Mm.
At school, we do go every day, Monday to Friday, but it's still few hours at school, and they spend more time in the home. And then at home, the parents thinking, whatever I need to teach the child at school, they should be teaching the child. And that responsibility is not for the teacher at school, because they should be going to school with values that have already been instilled in them, with qualities that have already been instilled in them. So what they get from school, if it is not in line with what they have been taught at home and what the scripture has to say, they are able to easily reject it because they know that it's not part of who they are and it's not part of their faith culture.
Sure.
But if we don't do that early, then we are most likely to teach them when they've already been taught. And it's more difficult to do so.
All right. We are going to take a break, and then, family, you can talk to us. The lines are open for you on 012-334-1322. I saw another family member trying to call in, and Muruti was still ministering, so I couldn't just, you know, cut Muruti. But, yeah, you can call in and talk to us on 012-334-1322. We're talking about protecting our children and training them to walk with God. And Muruti says it starts with us. We become that, and then our children will follow suit. And yes, you can also share your comments and your comments with us right there on our WhatsApp, be it it's a recorded voice note, or you can just text it. And you can send that all to 082-657-2729. It's 082-657-2729. With James Ferdinand Van Zyl. I don't want to laugh. I just saw that on your WhatsApp there. So thank you for the laughter, though. And yeah, family, you can comment. I'm streaming live on Facebook. And you can also send us an SMS on 37871. Become that which you want your children to be. Become that which you want your children to be. It starts with you. What a challenge, but all things are doable through Christ who strengthens us.
Godly Revolution, 16 June 2023, Leaven de Woord Main Campus, Brumeria, Pretoria. The ultimate Christian youth worship event of the year is back. Don't miss Godly Revolution on 16 June 2023. Come and enjoy award-winning artist DJ Maestro, One Crown, Minka Brits, Fusion Band, Hillsong SA, and more. With life-changing worship music and testimonies. Over the years, this event has impacted thousands of young lives. Invite all your friends to an unforgettable evening at Leven de Woord Church, Main Campus in Brumeria, Pretoria on Youth Day, 16 June, from 5 p.m. to 9 p.m. By far the best way to celebrate Youth Day. Tickets are 200 rand per person on quicker.co.za.
News with a kingdom perspective. Listen to Spectrum Fridays from 4 p.m. on Radio Pulpit 657 a.m.
I want to look back. Sim, face to face, finish my race. I get a moving forward, determined to reach my goal. I'm moving forward, I'm pressing towards the mark. Won't let anything hold me back. I'm moving
get us in face to face. I look forward to the day where we'll one day hear the Lord say.
This is Heart to Heart with Sibongile Mofokeng on Radio Pulpit. Heart to Heart.
Now, family, Godly Revolution and Radio Pulpit have great news for moms during the month of May. With Godly Revolution's Mom Taxi offer, we are giving the first 200 moms the opportunity to buy a large group ticket for only 1,000 rands plus handling fee, and fill your mom's taxi with 6 people and pay only for 5. SMS the word MOM to 37871 or WhatsApp the word MOM to 0826572729. You will then receive a direct ticket link, reserve the seats for your group, and scroll down the Quicket ticket platform to the MOM's taxi offer. Click and receive discounts on the tickets. And this promotion runs from the 12th to the 22nd of May. And yes, family, Godly Revolution is on the 16th of June at Living Water Brumeri. Is the best way for families to celebrate their youth day.
Tapelo ya motho yo lukileng ena le matla. Tswela pele go rapelela Radio Pulpit moshumong o re o dirang Afrika Borwa le ka ntlhagamelwane ya yona.
Plug in, feel the pulse on Heart to Heart with Sibongile Mofokeng on Radio Pulpit.
Give you the sounds of Nqubeko Mbatha moving forward. And yes, I'm not alone. I am with Pastor Sublime Mkhonto. We're talking about protecting our children and also training them to walk with God. Now, Muruti said it starts with us. It starts with us. We start modeling it in front of our children. Let them see us do it, and then they will follow suit. And family, you can talk to us right here on Heart to Heart. The lines are opened on 012-334-1322. Alternatively, you can drop us a WhatsApp or Telegram on 0826572729. It's 0826572729. Alternatively, you can drop us an SMS at 37871. Do remember that your SMS will cost you 150. Muruti, let's take a family member on the line and then come back to you. Hi, family. How are you?
I'm blessed beyond measure. How are you?
Ngikhona babunkosi. Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Amen. Mfundisi Mkhonto, ninjani lapho?
Siyaphila njani, baba?
Hawu, Jesu inkosi yabusa.
Hey, siyabonga baba. Siyabonga kakhulu.
Yebo. Sisibongile. Hey, yabona sinenkinga thina bazalwane.
Yeah.
Kazi kunabazalwane ukuthi iBhayibheli silifunde masesontweni kuphela.
Eish, I was going to ask umfundisi that. Yes, umfundisi. Yes, baba unkosi.
Ekhaya abantwana sibakhuza ngengqondo yethu, hayi ngezwi likaNkulunkulu.
Yeah.
Awumniki umntwana iBhayibheli afunde abone imistake yakhe from ezwini likaNkulunkulu.
Mm.
Umkhuza ngengqondo yakho. Sisibongile, nginendodakazi la.
Yeah.
Le ndodakazi ikhulele endlini kaNkulunkulu. Imiracle yona ngokwayo. Ngobe yayingahlali for 7 months esiswini sikamamayo.
Okay.
Yaqala ukudlala umama yasenkonzweni.
Yeah.
Khona manje ina 16 years.
Mm.
Iwupastor wama-teenagers.
Mm.
Mm. Ikhule ngezwi.
Mm.
Everything is avele esikolweni athi umntwana omunye uthe wathi or uthisha uthe wathi ngimkhombe eBhayibhelini.
Mm.
Uthi vula iveseli so atshelwe ilezwi likaNkulunkulu ukuthi le nto le kufanele ayihendlele ngayiphi indlela.
Mm.
Asisebenzeni nabantu bethu ngaleyo ndlela. Uqinisile umfundisi nokuthi abantwana babheka ukuthi wena wenza njani.
Mm.
Kwakunesisho sesintu esithi inkala i-crab.
Mm.
Yabona i-crab endala ukuthi thina sihambe straight sihamba ngesandla.
Mm.
Manje nayo umntwana ubheka umzali ukuthi uphila yiphi impilo.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Babunkosi. Wow, family, Babunkosi is saying that, you know, he said something very that touched my heart, that saddened actually my heart, when he says, most of us, we do not even use the word to reprimand our children. When we are at home, we only read the Bible when we are in church. And so when we are at home, we say things the way we see them fit according to our minds. And so we do not rely on the word of God to even discipline our children. And I believe that we really need to repent from such. We really need to repent from such as parents and start doing things the godly way, the right way. And he says that his daughter is a child who is a miracle herself. She stayed for only 7 months in the mom's womb, and then she was born, and she's a miracle on her own. And she says, you know, my daughter has become the pastor to all teenagers, and it doesn't matter what's happening, she would also refer, even at school, refer them to the word of God, because that's who she is, and this is what she got from home. And he says it needs to start with us, as Muruti says, let it start with us, Babunkosi says. And this is a challenge, Muruti, and I think we need to turn things around as parents. Do things right as parents. We need to repent from this. We can't be reading the scriptures when we are in church, fella. When the pastor says, let's open to the book of John, that's when we open. What happens when we are at home? So it means there's a lot that we need to correct as parents.
Yeah, there's definitely a lot that we need to correct as parents. I sometimes tell them at our church that one of the ways to know whether a parent is prayerful and committed to God or not is to look at their children inside the church. So sometimes you look at them and they can't sing even a single song, they can't pray, they can't even study the word while we are busy with the word. And it literally shows you where they come from. And the parent, when he or she is at church, they are so powerful. But at home, they are not doing all that. So it becomes a challenge. It becomes a very serious challenge. That is why I'm actually saying we have to become it ourselves.
Yeah.
Whatever I want to see in my children. Remember, if ever there are going to be fruits, there has to be a seed.
Mm-hmm.
And then in a seed, there will be a tree, and then branches, and then fruits. And in fruits, so it can become a transgenerational thing.
Mm.
But it starts with me as a seed. Whatever I want my children to become as my fruits, I must become it myself.
Right.
And that is why one of the ways to teach them to pray is not just to tell them to pray, but it's to pray with them.
Yeah, let them see you do it.
Yes, let them see you do it. Because on the other hand, the spirit of prayer is not only taught, but it's also caught.
Mm.
So they can't catch it unless it's there. So that is why Jesus would speak about prayer in two dimensions. He would say, actually, the disciples would say, teach us how to pray.
Mm.
And then at some point, they come to him and they say, teach us to pray.
Mm.
Because it's one thing to be taught how to pray, so you get to know the pattern. But when they teach us to pray, it's now a practical thing. Let's do it.
Mm.
So I think we need to master that and pray with our children, and then they learn how to pray on their own from
right.
what we have taught them.
Right. Frank Jacobs or Jacobs says, amen. And Obu James Ferdinand Fanzel says, teaching children to pray short prayers, teaching them thanking for their food and illustrated Bible stories is a good start. So you teach them short prayers so that they develop and grow from there. And also to give thanks. And thank you so much, Obud, for that. And I think you model it. They hear you doing it. Because, you know, I was watching a certain documentary, and these people, I don't even think, it's not a documentary, it's a reality TV. And I don't know if they know Christ as the Lord, but what I saw them do was, the mother, whenever she would get something from the children, she would say, thank you. thank you for doing this for me, you know, thank you for this and that. And then one day she buys something for the child, and the child doesn't even think, but she's complaining about it. No, I didn't want the pink one. And then they take her to the site and they're like, okay. Oh, it wasn't the mother who bought it. It was somebody else from outside who bought what the child wants, but it wasn't exactly how she desired it to be. She wanted a blue one and they bought a pink one. And so she was complaining and they said, but you know, we should be grateful because there are some children who do not even have this. You didn't even say thank you. Should we take it back? And I know Pastor Ngaka Sekese also talks about other parents who would even say to the child, they would teach them from the word and say, this is the fruit of the spirit. And the child would come and do something that is that shows disrespect or ungratefulness. And they would sit down when they after the whole thing and they say, what kind of a fruit were you showing up with? What is that fruit? Is it there in the word? And then the child says no. And then that calls for what? For punishment. All right. So what kind of punishment? So I think we also need to show those fruits. We also need to show that thankfulness that you know, it starts with us. It starts with us.
Yeah.
And Moruti, how do we protect them from themselves? Because sometimes they themselves become a danger to themselves because of all the voices that are speaking in their lives.
I think the best way to protect them from themselves sometimes would be for them to know that they don't know everything. You see, the danger of knowing everything is that even when you don't know, you're not going to know that you don't know. Mm-hmm. And you're going to be arrogant, and you're not going to listen to anyone because you think you know best.
Mm.
But it should be clear from the word go that as a parent, I don't know everything.
Mm-hmm.
And you yourself, you are never going to know everything.
Mm.
And therefore, you should have a listening ear to hear from those that have gone ahead of you. Like me as your parent, you should be able to listen to me because experience has taught me one or two things that you may not know where you are right now.
Mm-hmm.
And if you can't listen to me, your children also are not going to listen to you. So they have to know that.
Mm.
It's humility. It's something you instill in them,
mm-hmm.
and if they can know humility, then they can know how to listen and pay attention. And on the other hand, you have to also teach them to listen with the ears of the word.
Mm.
So if I'm listening to someone speaking to me, I should be able to check it like the Berean Church. Is it in line with scripture?
The word, yeah.
Yes, is it in line with the word of God? Because someone could be teaching me something that is good, but it's not right for me.
Mm.
It's not right for me as a Hebrew child, mm-hmm. if I may put it that way for our understanding purposes.
Mm-hmm.
It's not right for me as a Hebrew child. So I should be able to say, this is good, but it's not part of our kingdom culture.
Mm.
So I'm not going to take it because it's not in line with me. So, but you see, at the end of the day, it takes us back to the point whereby we say, you must teach them yourself as a parent. And if you can teach them, you would have protected them from a whole lot of things that could be happening out there. Now, let me give you an example. When they go to school, they meet with friends and they talk about sex. They talk about all these things like drinking and all these things. They talk about all these things. And the best way to get them to do what is right and what is in line with the word is to teach them yourself. This is the way.
Yeah.
If you can't give them that yourself, they will definitely listen to others and listen to their friends. And there's going to be peer pressure, because if you don't do what everyone else is doing, it feels like you're a fool. They can even call you an idiot. And you are most likely to feel left behind and left out. So you have to experiment and you have to do it in order to make them happy. But if I have been taught at home, I know that this may be good right now, but it leads to destruction. So I'm not going to go with it, because at home I've been taught. So that teaching has become my protection now. So as a parent, actually, at the end of the day, there should be nothing, there should be no subject I can't talk about with my child.
Yeah,
I can't shy away from any subject, because this is life, and they live it out there, and it's reality. So if certain things I can't talk about, I'm also not protecting my children then. So I have to talk about everything. I talk to my daughter about sex, and I talk to my daughter about boyfriends, and she tells me if she has a crush on someone, and then we discuss it based on the weight. And I strongly believe that that's how it should be. And if I can teach her everything, the beautiful part is that at the end of the day, if there is any teaching she's receiving out there, or anyone coming with gimmicks out there, she's gonna come to me first. So I'm gonna be the fortress she can run to at any given time, because she knows that I'm there for her. I'm not a lion to her, but I'm a father to her, and a father who can be very friendly to her. So we get to talk about everything, and I think that protects them big time.
Sure. Muruti, thank you so much for talking to us about this, and I think it's time we say to the Lord, as adults, we repent and we want to do things right, because what kind of a generation are we raising if we ourselves are defeated in these areas? And so we pray unto the Lord to repent and start doing things right. I have seen children who are born to doctors, they themselves becoming doctors. I have seen even some of born to pastors, they become pastors, and some musicians, but they do what their parents have been doing. I know that sometimes we and I've learned and I've heard of generational blessings that go, you know, but I've also seen that some, it's not even generational, it's something that they took from home and they loved and they became that. And they became that, and some even become a better version of their parents. And so it is doable. I mean, we should bring up the others who are of our own kind. The Lord Jesus says, "You will do even greater things than you saw me do." And so it has to be like that, even where children are concerned. And I see Gogo Macy Maureen saying, "Amen." Gogo Maureen Sijake, thank you so much for tuning in and being with us even today. Muruti, I'm going to just allow you to say your last words to the family, and then we pray for parents. Parenting is not an easy job. I don't think it's easy.
No, it's not.
If we can just say, take it to the Lord in prayer for his guidance and lordship, we really need to hear his voice as the Lord Holy Spirit guiding us, because bringing up a soul, it's not bringing up something it's huge, it's precious, and so the Lord has entrusted us with those souls. Can we just say, have your last words, and then take it to the Lord in prayer?
Okay. Thank you, my dear sister. Every parent should understand that the worst thing that can happen to a parent that knows God is to raise a child that doesn't know God. That's the worst thing that can happen to every parent. Number two, it is every parent's responsibility to pray for their children and also pray with their children. Every parent should dedicate some time every day to pray with their children, and then you should also pray for your children, lay hands on your children and bless them. There is no voice that is bigger than your voice in your children's life. It's important to get that. With those words, can I please say a word of prayer?
Let's pray.
Our Father and our God, we are so grateful for the gift of family that you have given to us. We are so grateful, Father, in Jesus' name, that each and every one of us belong to a family. And you allowed us, oh God, to be raised in those families. We pray, Father, in Jesus' name, for the parents. We pray for wisdom. We pray, oh God, for wisdom. In the name of Jesus Christ, wisdom to raise their families the godly way. We pray for that wisdom, oh God. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray that, oh God, in Jesus' name, you will enable them. Like Paul says, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. We pray that, Father, in Jesus' name, you will give them divine enablement, oh God, in Jesus' name, and, oh God, a divine capability to be able to raise their children in the way of the Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray for patience. We pray in Jesus' name for mercy and grace, even as we raise our children the God's way. In the name of Jesus Christ, and we pray that, Father, you will bless our families, you will bless the parents, you will bless the children, and you will give peace to our families. In Jesus' mighty name, we declare, oh God, according to your word, you keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed upon you. So Lord, we declare peace, peace, shalom, shalom over every house, over every home, over every family. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray your protection. We pray your divine health. We pray, oh God, your preservation. We pray your prosperity over every family. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we thank you and we give you the praise. Amen and amen.
And amen. Thank you so much, Muruti. May the Lord keep keeping you. For family members seeking to talk to you directly, how do they get hold of you?
They can call me on 072-4237-625.
Can you repeat that?
Okay, 072-4237-625.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, my dear sister.
And I know that on Facebook, can we follow you also on Facebook? I know your Sublime SPM Konto there.
Yes, yes, yes. They can follow me even on Facebook.
Wow. Thank you so much, Muruti, for empowering us. Thank you for praying for us. And may God also keeping you until we talk to you again, Muruti. Have a blessed, blessed one.
Amen. Thank you so much. And thank you for the opportunity. I really appreciate it.
Welcome to the family.
Okay, sure. Thank you.
And that family is Pastor Sublime Elton Mkonto, all the way from Tulamahashi in Bushbuck Reach. If you'd like to be in contact with him, his numbers are 072-423-7625. 072-423-7625. And you can find him on Facebook as Pastor Sublime. Actually, it's Sublime Spear Mkonto on Facebook. Sublime Spear Mkonto. Going to give you the sounds of Nicole Simalin, My Shepherd, as the Lord is shepherding us in how we ought to bring up our children, how to protect and train them in their walk with him. And also, that will connect us to the 2 o'clock news bulletin.
The Lord is my shepherd and I shall not want. The Lord is my shepherd and I shall not want. Help me say,
the Lord
is my shepherd and I shall not want. The Lord is my shepherd and I shall not want. I shall not want, I shall not lack, I shall not do without any good thing. I shall not want, I shall not lack, I shall not do without any good thing. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. I shall not want, I shall not lack, I shall not do without any good thing. I shall not want, I shall not lack, I shall not do without any good thing. So who can stand against us when who?
657 Radio Pulpit News.
You're listening to Radio Pulpit. The time is 2 o'clock. I'm Sibongile Mofokeng with your 2 o'clock news bulletin. And it is 14 degrees Celsius in Pretoria. Despite challenges such as high prices and rolling blackouts, South African small and medium-sized enterprises remain optimistic about their survival. According to a recent report by Sage, 83% of business decision makers are confident of their company's success within the next 12 months, with 41% attributing their confidence to working more efficiently, and inflation is cited as a significant barrier, impacting 77% of South African SMEs. However, local businesses are more likely to add new products and services, prioritize technology adoption, and implement cutting-edge technologies in the future. The Western Cape Department of Economic Finance and Economic Opportunities, together with 12 employers in the business process outsourcing sector, recently hosted a recruitment drive at the Athlone Stadium in Cape Town. Unemployed youth between the ages of 18 and 34 with a grade 12 or equivalent qualification were interviewed by operators, which will employ 1,000 of those interviewed in the BPO sector. MEC Mariel Wenger says the sector is a vibrant and growing sector of the province's economy.
The event is the first of five to be held this year, bringing the number of opportunities offered to 5,000. Successful candidates will receive a 12-month on-the-job learnership within a BPO company, including a monthly stipend. After completing the program, each beneficiary will receive an accredited qualification equivalent to an NQF Level 3.
The Presidential Climate Commission of South Africa has revealed the regular breakdowns of coal-fired power plants have unintentionally led to a reduction in carbon dioxide emission. The ongoing issue of load shedding, with power outages lasting up to 10 hours a day, has limited emission from factories. According to the director of commission, Crispian Oliver, this unintended progress in curbing carbon emission is bringing South Africa closer to its 2030 target, and the country aims to reduce its emission to between 350 and 420 megatons of carbon dioxide equivalent to 2030. Limpopo Health MEC Popira Matuba has activated the Tomo Clinic to provide 24-hour service to communities around Tomo Village and Giani. The MEC made a commitment during her 2023-2024 budget speech to have most of the clinics in the province open for 24-hour healthcare services. And the MEC's spokesperson, Talibali Muaba, says for years there has been an increased demand for 24-hour medical services in rural areas especially.
The department has pledged to have most clinics open 24 services, which have come as a relief to the communities. Now, the MEC is making a plea to all the traditional leaders and communities to protect these clinics. You recall that we had had several criminal incidents where staff members and security personnel were attacked during their time of duty.
And finally, Cape Town achieved a second place among 482 cities in the number of observations recorded and fourth place in the number of species recorded category during the recent City Nature Challenge. The competition took place between the 28th of last month and the 1st of this month. Deputy Mayor Eddie Andrews says the Cape Town participants were able to record 52,518 observations and 3,847 species across the city.
First place in the recorded observations category was La Paz in Bolivia with 126,435 observations. In the recorded species category, first place also went to La Paz with 5,344 species. A special thanks to all the individuals from our city who helped identify observations that were recorded during the City Nature Challenge.
And that brings us to the end of these good news by... Yes, put together for us by Newsflash News Agency. Our next newscaster will be at 3 o'clock with Germany, Johan Els.
Wash away my stains.
That is Joy Celebration and Love Like Jesus is the title of the song we gave to you. And Nondumiso Shezi is on the lead right there, my family. Beautiful sounds on 657 a.m.
Faith, hope and love. Experience victory in your life on 657 a.m.
13 minutes, it is just after 2 on 657 a.m. Radio Pulpit, your daily companion. Family, Godly Revolution and Radio Pulpit have great news for moms during the month of May. With Godly Revolution's Moms Taxi offer, we are giving the first 200 moms the opportunity to buy a large group ticket for only 1,000 rands plus handling fee. fill your mom's taxi with six people and pay only for five. SMS the word mom to 37871 or WhatsApp the word mom to 082-657-2729 and you will then receive a direct ticket link. Reserve the seats for your group and scroll down the Quicket ticket platform to the mom's taxi offer. Click and receive discounts on the tickets. And this promotion runs from the 12th to the 22nd of May. Godly Revolution, 16th June at Living Word Brumeria in the best way, or is the best way, my family, for families to celebrate the Youth Day. Do remember that we are calling on all the youth to come celebrate this awesome day with us at Godly Revolution on the 16th of June. I'm going to be connecting to Pastor Radebe. We are talking to fathers and we are going to take the sounds of Pastor K. Kaleni Kalena, if you please. No one greater. And we are connecting to Muruti.
From north to south, I search for God. God His promises are true. From east to west, I found no God.
East to west, I found no God.
For none compares to Your wondrous love.
None compares to Your wondrous love.
I searched all over for a God.
I searched all over for a God.
Who could lay His life for humanity? I searched all over for a God, but none compares to Your wondrous love. You are good, You are kind. There is no one better, no one greater than You.
Your life, I just want you to just raise your voice right now. Declare He is a kind God. If you know God has been good in your life, raise your voice and declare. There is no one greater than our God. He is a good God, all right. A kind God He is. Somebody.